man.
We need to talk about Eileen.
We've talked about Eileen.
No, you have, Mrs. Connor.
Well, he who pays the piper, is he?
Yeah, exactly. Now, please just get back to your machines and start banging some tunes out.
Are you going to reinstate her or not?
Look, Carla, it was just a misunderstanding. There's no need for us all to fall out.
Yeah, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll count to three, and if you're not all stitching knickers by the time I finish, then
stitching nothing till Eileen gets her job back.
You what?
We're going on strike.
Oh, really?
Oh, I'd seriously reconsider that, girls. You know, all mobs can turn ugly, but really, you've got nowhere to go.
Please, spare us the cheap shots. We're walking.
Oh, come on, girls. There's no need to overreact.
No, let them go. But, you know, if you walk out that door, you shut it behind you and it stays shut, there's no coming back.
Well, that's a chance we'll have to take. Good luck with the order.
And your machine is here by tomorrow morning. Because I told you we've got a big order to fill.
Well, there must be somebody. I mean, there's meant to be a reception.
Not half as sorry as I am. Thank you. Bye bye.
Hey, love. Right, okay. Where's all your stuff? Thanks,
I don't know and I don't care. I'm done with them ungrateful beggars.
No joy, I'm afraid.
Well, what's happened?
The peasants are revolting.
They've walked out on us, haven't they? Left us in a lurch.
Yeah? Why have they done that?
They sacked Eileen yesterday.
Oh, whoa. You never said anything to me.
Well, do you tell me when there's the steward's inquiry at Fontwell? It's my business. What do you care?
Of course I care. I mean, how are you going to shift that order if you've got no staff?
Oh, we'll just have to keep phoning around the agencies, yeah. Won't we?
There are plenty of machinists out there. Oh.
Yes, there are, love, but you need them here now. Look, did you sack Eileen because of this business with the funeral?
I told you, I sacked her because she was the reason we missed the first deadline.
Yeah, I know, but... Even so, it's a funeral.
Listen, she didn't ask me. She just walked out and left me in the lurch. I can't have people doing that on me.
She has had a lot on her plate lately.
So have I.
Yeah, and if the truth be told, that's probably why things have got this far. I think you might have taken things out on Eileen, you know, just overreacted.
No! No way! No, I needed to make an example of her, and the same goes for the rest of them. Look, no, they've made the beds.
Shooting villagers never works, especially when you're dependent on them. You know, and them bits of our lives that we can control, we need to keep on track for sanity's sake.
So what are you suggesting?
Well, if I know your girls will be in the Rovers, I think we should go over there, we should have a peace talk before this gets completely out of hand.
Oh.
Hey. Evening, ladies. Sean. Listen, can we buy you all a drink?
Oh, great. I'll have a treble Bacardi.
No, not so fast.
I'm not actually rewarding you for stabbing me in the back, no. But we might be able to come to some agreement.
You can buy us off with a round of drinks.
Well, it's not a bad off.
Look, come on, nobody wants this, OK? I mean, how are we going to meet that order if we don't have all hands to pump?
Including Eileen's.
Yes, she's a good machinist.
Listen, she can be world-flaming champion. She's no good to me if she's not sat at a machine, is she? However, I might reconsider if you lot all... Forget about this strike stuff and go back to work, OK?
You can on strike?
Yeah, until you get your job back.
Oh, wait a minute, there's no need.
There's every need. We are not coming back till we get a guarantee that Eileen will be reinstated.
I really appreciate what you've done, but I don't want to be reinstated.
There you go. You heard her. She don't want to be reinstated. Eh?
Steve's offered me my old job back at Streetcars and I'm having a belly full of working for you. I bet he's flaming hand off.
Hold on. If we put our jobs on the line for you, talk about ungrateful.
Hey, hang on a sec, I never asked you to do any of this.
No, and I will be seeing you all tomorrow, 8:30 sharp, on the dot, at work.
Okay.
What about our drinks?
Come on, I'll get the drinks, and it's the least I can do under the circumstances.